Hi, today's video is about the pros and cons of living here in the River Valley, Arizona. So I'm going to tell you the towns. We're going to talk about Cottonwood, Clarkdale, Cornville, Rimrock, Jerome, and Camp Verde. So those are the towns that make up Verde Valley. Now, here I live in Sedona. I've got a village of Oak Creek and Sedona. We kind of border the Verde Valley. We're at the northmost border of Verde Valley. So a lot of the things are similar here in Sedona, like the weather and the temperature, but then you do have a whole new vibe going on in Verde Valley, Arizona. Now, how did I compile this information? Well, I started off by calling an old friend, and we had a 2 hour chit chat girls catch up on the phone, and she used to live in all of the Verde Valley towns, Clarkdale, Cottonwood, Camp Verde. She may have even lived in Cornville, and I know Rimrock for over 20 years, and occasionally I would come visit her, but we had a nice catch-up chat on what she thought about that, plus my own experiences. I actually go to Verde Valley a lot, go to Cottonwood to do shopping and get my car worked on and that kind of deal. So even though I'm in Village of Oak Creek, I'm a little familiar with it. And then if I was a little stumped, of course I did a Google search. That is how I came up with the material that I'm talking to you about in this video. So the first pro I'm going to talk about is that Old Town Cottonwood and even Old Town Clarkdale have a very nice vibe, friendly vibe amongst the tourists and the residents that live there. It's just a nice place to hang out, and if you're living there, that's might where you might go on the weekends to, have a drink or get something to eat. And I even know in the village, my neighbors used to tell me about places in Old Time Cottonwood that they went to all the time on a Friday or Saturday night. So there's a lot of nice things to do there. Old Town Cottonwood also has something they call the Old Town Center for the Arts. So here's where you're going to hear live music, live entertainment, any type of shows like that. And in the surrounding area, you're going to have restaurants and shops and activities. So it's a nice little addition to Old Town Cottonwood. There are also restaurants and wineries nearby in Verde Valley that go through the whole valley. Some of the wineries wind through all of the Verde Valley towns. In Old Town Cottonwood, there is the Tavern Hotel, which is a nice place to stay over, and then there's the Tavern Grill, which is a nice restaurant a lot of people like. They have decent prices, not really too pricey, and a lot of things in the menu and a kind of fun vibe. There are also other restaurants nearby, like Nick's, which is supposed to be more of a high-end restaurant where you've got Italian food or steak, and a little higher price, but kind of that nicer, more relaxed and classy vibe you might want if you're taking your wife or girlfriend out on a romantic evening. So now, one thing I heard is some of these restaurants here, the Tavern, Nick's, Grapes, which is in Jerome, where I've eaten before, Haunted Herring Burger, all of these are owned by the same group called the Haunted Group, which is really kind of fun. They have stories about these restaurants that they own and the websites, which I could put down below. And Haunted Herring Burger has a great reputation here amongst the locals. Now, the last time I went there, I met friends and we couldn't get a parking space, so we ended up at Grapes, but that was just as nice. And I've heard that the tavern used to be an old theater, so you might look nearby and see places where the theater seats used to be there. I haven't been in that, but that's one of the next places that I want to go when I'm out exploring Verde Valley. So another pro, of course, are the vineyards, the wineries, the wine tasting rooms, and there's beer gardens as well. So those are super popular, not only with the locals, but with the tourists as well. And what we have is something that they call the Verde Valley Wine Trail. And I can put a link to that below. But basically, see this map here, the Verde Valley wine trail goes through Cottonwood, Jerome, Sedona, Clarkdale, and Cornvale. And there's places to stop at the wineries and maybe taste wine, which is probably the whole reason you're on the trip, right? So there are 7 Arizona wineries, and they go through 8 tasting rooms on this Verde Valley wine trail, and supposedly it's a really fun experience. There's also beer gardens where you can see the nicely local brewed beer as well, and those places are a lot of fun. So one more pro is that there is actually a lot more to do in Verde Valley than just eat and drink. Even though I'm told it's a foodie's paradise, there are other things to do as well, like the Verde Valley Railroad. And I know I took that many years ago, and I thought we went to the Grand Canyon, but I might be confusing it with another tour. There you do like a 20-mile track around Verde Valley and see some of the nice sights from the train, and it's a very nice thing to do. There's also Touzegut National Monument, which has got these little limestone formations, and then there is the Dead Horse Ranch, which has camping, fishing, and hiking, if you're into that, which I always thought was a lot of fun. And then there's Montezuma's National Monument, which is different than Montezuma Well, but not Montezuma National Monument is cliff dwellings and left by the Native Indians. And when I was in 6th grade, we went there for a field trip, and the cliff dwellings are really low. I remember going in there, and then when I came out too soon, I hit the top of my head. so you have to crouch down in some of the places. You've got the Out of Africa Wildlife Park, which is supposed to be a lot of fun. I went to it when it was in the valley, but I've not seen it since it relocated here in Camp Verde. And finally, if you're a gambler, there's Cliff Castle Casino on the east side of the highway. Now, on the west side of the highway, same exit as another casino. And I'm sorry, I don't remember the name. I might have to update you with the name of that place for I can't remember. So there are 2 casinos very close to each other. Now, one more pro is that there's a mild climate here in Verde Valley. So again, Sedona being about the same elevation, Verde Valley might range from 4 to 5,000 feet above sea level. So the summers, while they're warm, they're not nearly as hot as Phoenix. So say if Phoenix is at 117 degrees, up here in Verde Valley, we're probably about 103. And then the same thing with Flagstaff. Not freezing like Flagstaff. Here we might get a little dusting of snow, but it'll melt off. Whereas in Flagstaff, you could have a blanket of snow all winter. And if it's, say, freezing in Flagstaff, it might be, you know, high 40s, say, on the daytime in the summer. So, there's also one thing to look at is the monsoons. Man, there's some places here where you're a little bit high and you look out over Mingus Mountain and you see the most amazing monsoons, and I think that's really fun. So another pro, one of the last ones I'm thinking of, is that it's actually more affordable to buy a house in Verde Valley than lots of the places in Phoenix, pretty much any place in Sedona and Flagstaff as well. So you can get a decent house that's affordable in a decent area. Now in Clarkdale, I'm seeing a bunch of new build neighborhoods that are going up, and they look really nice. And oh, by the way, I can take you to a new builder if you're interested in finding one of those. Cornvale, there were new builds. They may be all sold out. I would have to look into that. And then in Sedona, I noticed on the far west side, there seems to be some type of a maybe condo or townhouse complex going up. So that's something that could turn out to be very interesting as well. Now, the con is, and of course, this can happen everywhere and actually does happen anywhere, but there's some pockety areas. And when I say pockety, I mean there's some areas where there's nice homes and then you'll have 1 or 2 rundown homes next door. So there occasionally you'll have a nice house and a block away are some very rundown homes that you have to drive by on your way home and get annoyed. So just remember when you're looking to look in the immediate areas around you too, because again, just about any place in Arizona or probably the whole country can find these pockets of rundown homes, but just something to be aware of when you're shopping for a home in Verde Valley. Now, one of the first cons I'm going to bring up is there's not really a huge variety of jobs here. Like in Phoenix, you probably can find a job doing just about anything. Here in Verde Valley, it might be a little less fluid like that. You would have jobs, say the top employers are Verde Valley Medical Center. So if you're a healthcare worker, you've got good opportunities here. Also, if you're a teacher, the education group might be a good place to work here. Hospitality again, there's a car lot here. Some of the major employers here besides Verde Valley Medical Center and the school system might be, there's a company called Molding Graphics where they imprint different company logos on promotional type products, you know, notebooks, clothing, that kind of thing. There is Laser Light, which makes gun sights. There's a company called Granger, and I know it's not related to the Granger, you know, industrial catalog, but it does some type of manufacturing here. So again, slightly more limited jobs unless you're in one of those industries, hospitality, healthcare, that kind of thing. So there is another con I want to talk to you about, which is kind of a dark side of Verde Valley. I have not seen so much of this myself personally, but then again, I live in the village, but I've heard that there can be a little bit of a drug problem here. So when I say drug problem, I'm mostly thinking of meth, because I've heard of people say, oh, you know, I knew that guy, but he was a meth user, or, oh, my neighbor was a meth user. So I've heard of people personally knowing in Cottonwood of meth users, and I don't know any meth users myself. So if you have teenagers, something to think about. Also, the opiate crisis has hit the Verde Valley as well. I have been hearing, or maybe last year, I was hearing on the radio just overdose of people taking fentanyl that was tainted, or something that was tainted with fentanyl, and you know, young people dying. It's very sad. This is a problem all over the country, of course, but it's something to look out for. And one last thing is I've heard about suicides being high. I hear ads on the radio for suicide prevention. Now, it's possible that's going on everywhere else too, but just if you have teenagers or younger, just be aware and, you know, just watch your kids for odd behavior. Another pro or a con, depending on your perspective, is that Rimrock and Camp Verde are kind of cowboy towns. In fact, the mascot of Camp Verde High School is the Cowboys. So if you're not a big fan of cowboys, or you don't like ranch property, homes that could have horses or chickens on it, then you might want to avoid these two towns. Now, it again is your perspective. Some people like that. I had many cousins that would swoon over any body that resembled a cowboy. So, I mean, maybe that's what you like, or if you don't like, just know that there's kind of a cowboy vibe in those two towns. Now, I know Camp Verde has a lot of the feed stores. They also have gun stores. They have ranch property, a lot of antique shops or thrift shops or dollar stores that you see in Camp Verde area. So another thing that you want to know about on kind of the pro side is there are a lot of fun festivals there. I've been told to go to Fort Verde Days, but then this year I think it was canceled because of the virus, which was the same thing of the Wine and Pecan Festival, which sounds actually like a ton of fun, except for the fact that I'm allergic to pecans. I've heard of the Corn Festival. I know that was canceled this year. And there's other activities around Halloween. So I know, I've heard Clarkdale has a lot of fun stuff that happens on Halloween. The kids do a little costume parade. They bring out the fire trucks. They do like a trunk or treat, and there's candy and that kind of thing. Maybe canceled this year. Now, I know last year in Sedona, it was the first Halloween I'd live in Sedona. My son drove up from Phoenix. He's 19 at the time, and we went to Uptown Sedona, and it was a lot of fun. They had merchants, everybody's dressed up, lots of kids came, they had candy, the merchants were giving out candy, they had balloons, they had really fun costumes, and you would just walk around in little shops and, you know, look around. It was lots of fun. So I don't know about this year. That could be canceled now. I did hear talk of them doing some type of ghost walk through Cook Cemetery, but those were going to be limited events because you couldn't put too many at the same time. So, and again, maybe twice a day on that Friday and Saturday night of Halloween. We will have to just keep watching the local newspapers. And if I see anything exciting come up close to Halloween, I might give you that information. So my name's Dawn Dickinson. I live here in beautiful Village Boat Creek. I sell real estate in northern Arizona. Text me, email me, call me if you have any questions about that. And I post videos about northern Arizona topics every single week. So I hope to see you back here next week. Please like or subscribe if you like this video. Thank you. Have a good week.